Yeah, can I say this? Earlier on, you said people are being harassed by the police, but before they're being harassed, how did they come here? They jump all the countries. They jump Mozambique. They jump Uganda. They come here to South Africa, you know. And the question, documented or undocumented, is neither here nor there for me. You know, it doesn't matter whether documented or not, because you might have 15 million foreigners, you document them all. You still have a problem, you know, because people who come here, they should have scarce skills. You don't come here to cut hair. You don't come here to open a spaza shop. We've got those things. You know, you're not adding value. You know, you're duplicating what we already have.
But then what happens in a case where, you know, as South Africans, because we've seen it with, you know, the violence that sparked in Soweto just a few years ago, where it then emerged that some even locals are leasing their stores to foreign nationals because they are simply not able to operate then in that space.
A desperate man will eat the last endangered species. So you cannot, you know, blame people who are poor, who do whatever that, you know, is at their disposal. You know, sometimes people will lease them, their houses to foreign nationals because of, you know, unemployment and so forth. But their greater responsibility lies in our government. They must make sure that our borders, you know, are secured. You know, people don't just walk in and out, you know. You go to Zimbabwe, you can't do what Zimbabweans are doing here. I mean, you go to the CBD, you know, people have been stabbed in broad daylight. You go to the north of Joburg, a particular crime when it's happening, you know that it's a particular citizen. You know, when people are installing that night in their houses, you know that it's a Zimbabwean. When it comes to drugs, you know a particular nation dominating that, you know. And when you raise these issues, you're told that you're being xenophobic. So people must go back to their countries, you know. Well, we can take ourselves.
So would South Africa be better without foreign nationals, according to you?
It will be much, much, much better, because I'll tell you this, we can take those people who provide scarce skills. You know, you can't come here and be a TV presenter. You've got a surplus of that. You can't come here and become a technician. You've got a surplus of that. You know, we've got unemployment in this country. We've got housing issues. I mean, look at the east of Joburg. You know, Rosettenville and all that. People, you know, they've captured houses, they've captured buildings. We should be housing our people there. Our country would be much, much, much better and much cleaner. I mean, look at the medical, the healthcare center. It has collapsed. You go to Baragwanath, you go to Hilbro, you go to General, you go to Helen Joseph, you go to everywhere. You know, people, you know, when they're pregnant, they jump the border. People from Zambia come here to do operations. If you needed an operation today, you go to Baragwanath. You know, you'll be told that there's a waiting list. You'll probably see a pediatrician or orthopedic next year, because in front of you there are people who are not supposed to be here. That is nonsense.
And Sheikh Hasi, you want
to respond to that? The fact of the matter is, South Africa has been isolated from the world.